Oh, ladies and gentlemen, what's this thing doing here? Welcome back to the Dinosaur Channel. This is your home on YouTube for all things dinosaur and prehistoric. And today we'll be covering our first non-dinosaur from Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, the Pteranodon. So if you enjoy Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom and you want to learn more about your favorite dinosaurs, make sure you subscribe and turn on notifications for this channel so you don't miss a single dinosaur quick dive. Make sure you leave us a dinosaur size thumbs up, comment down below your favorite dinosaur, and let's jump right in to the Pteranodon. The Pteranodon. Yes, not a dinosaur. That might confuse you a little bit, but it is a flying reptile. The name Pteranodon means wing toothless, or toothless wing if you want to say it correctly, I guess. So where and how long ago did this ancient flying lizard live? The Pteranodon lived during the Cretaceous period of the Mesozoic era, about 70 to 90 million years ago. And most fossils of the Pteranodon were found in what is now the United States of America. Important to remember, yes, this is a side note, Pteranodon, and I'll say this again, Pteranodons were not dinosaurs. They were pterosaurs, a group of reptiles that had developed the ability to fly. Although they are frequently grouped up with dinosaurs, please, my friends, remember they are not dinosaurs. Doesn't mean they're not awesome, but yeah, just remember that, okay? Side note over. So what did this amazing flying animal look like? Pteranodons were big, having wingspans reaching 20 feet long. That's massive. Luckily, these animals were so common that so many of them have been found in the fossil record, over 1,000 individuals. So some other amazing features besides their wingspan is their cool crest and beak. Their skull had a giant crest attached to the top of it, which could have been used for displays of maturity, sexual readiness, or maybe just for general badassery while you're flying. It could have been used as a sail or even as a rudder for the air. We don't know exactly, but we do know that it looked freaking awesome, and it gave the Pteranodon some major cool points. Besides that, like the name of the Pteranodon mentioned, it had a beak that was toothless, and a giant beak at that. Many pterosaurs that evolved before the Pteranodon actually did have teeth in their beak, so it was odd to find this one not having a tooth, but beak, tooth. The Pteranodon had no teeth! It was tooth dependent, tooth and teeth dependent, tooth and dependent, teeth and dependent. Alright, alright. This is hands down the most popular pterosaur, maybe besides the pterodactyl. So let's find out why exactly that is. Well, being found in the heyday of dinosaur and prehistoric discovery definitely aided the Pteranodon in becoming one of the most famous flying animals of all time. Most notably, it was featured in early renditions of King Kong and Sir Conan Arthur Doyle's Lost World. And furthermore, our beloved Pteranodon was featured for the first time at the end of the sequel to Jurassic Park, The Lost World Jurassic Park, where we saw it for quite a few seconds just spreading its wing, and then it was featured again in Jurassic Park 3, Jurassic World, and Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. In Jurassic Park 3, it kind of sealed the deal in many hearts of dinosaur and prehistoric animal lovers, where it was shown to be living in a giant bird cage on Isla Sorna, or Site B. So what did the Pteranodon feed on, and how did it behave? Well, due to not having any teeth, it's probably safe to say the Pteranodon ate a lot of fish. Also, fish bones have been found inside of the fossilized stomachs of Pteranodon, so that's pretty much proof. Other than that, it might have fed on some invertebrates that were an easy catch, and it might have even scavenged for other corpses of dead animals that existed in the area. And as for how it lived its daily life, it probably lived very close to any source of water, whether it be the ocean, a river, a stream, a lake. It would fly close to the water and scoop up fish using its beak, kind of like a modern day pelican. There are also some theories that it might have been able to fold its body and dive fully into the water to pick up prey, kind of like some modern birds do today. Gosh, that would have been really funny. Just imagine some fish swimming around being scared the crap out by a giant pterosaur diving into the water. Fish probably would have been like, gosh, that would have been funny. That's all, folks. That's the Pteranodon for you. I think that's our first non-dinosaur, and that went pretty smoothly. No problems there, right? If you guys enjoy the Pteranodon and other dinosaurs from Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, you gotta make sure you subscribe to this YouTube channel because we're covering every dinosaur and prehistoric animal that was in that movie. Also, make sure you turn on those notifications when you do subscribe so you don't miss a single video, and make sure you leave us a dinosaur-sized thumbs up and comment down below a dinosaur you would like to see in the future. Also, if you like this channel and you want to support us, you can send us a donation on PayPal. The link will be in the description, and we will see you guys in the next episode when we cover the famous, the amazing Triceratops. I'll see you then, ladies and gentlemen. Goodbye.